is just washing the, I call the covers, the notebooks. Don't do this if you don't have the same type of idea used. Because you want to get all the grease off of the cover, the silky ones. Now I'm taking some paint water and a paintbrush, and putting paint onto the notebook. And just paint as lines, I did the lines, do anything you want. Now I'll take some paper and put it onto the notebook. Not that one, so I think in this one we're going to do the same thing. Put some paint on it. Putting the paper on it, what it does is take some of the paint off of the board, off of the your painting surface to give you some cool designs. No, this didn't really work out. I was going to take alcohol and move the paint around. Didn't really work as well as I thought, but I like the effect it gave. Just put as much water or alcohol as you want on it. And then take some paint. Okay, this is actually from the water. And the same thing, you just put the paper on it. And that one's done too. This one, I did spell the word wrong. I was supposed to say notes, and I spelled it wrong. The nice thing that if it's still wet, it will wipe off. So if it's a no, it's not an option. This one, I didn't like how it turned out. It didn't turn out as well as I wanted to, like the other two. The other two, I liked how it turned out. Take that same piece of paper. Push it down and pull it away. This one I kind of tried now I'm getting my Sharpies out. Is there anything thinking about doing to taking the Sharpies out? I thought I tried to make like graffiti, but then I realized the Sharpie isn't that well. So that is what this is. When I'm fixing it. And now we're back. The camera is back on. So after a while, I took the paint to make it more look like confetti or sprinkles, whatever, and how they turned out as they have dried. Maybe you'll see the other two. Oh, there he goes. Yep. Okay. So that. Oh, yeah. Okay. So next part, right? Okay, so that I need to edit that and edit that part out. Okay. Okay, so you can take this can and you can put water in it and put it in your freezer for 24 hours. Now I'm gonna take a nail and hit it a bunch of times anywhere you want. You can even do a pattern if you want to. I don't show it, but when you are done, put some hot water in it to get the ice out. Hitting me like I am doing it when I get all of it out. And make sure you are very careful when you're doing this. So now I'm taking a screwdriver and kind of making it so it's not as pokey inside and put some beans in it. So the beans won't damage the bottom. Then don't have something to sit in. Okay, so this one, I'm going to take paper and put it on the outside of it. Like wrapping it like a present. Now, so we're gonna put beans in this one too. When do we get that? I think I show it. I show it. Pretty sure. Yep, beans. Make sure you let it dry for 24 hours, the glue. That's both the cans. Okay, what I'm doing here is taking plastic wrap and putting it all over the cup. So that you can square, put the clay on it. See how I did there? I smashed the clay on all of it. As much as you want. If you want to make it super, super smooth, you don't have to. I'm taking no, oh, I have water coming nearby so I can keep getting wet. You want it as wet as you can. Nice and smooth. Nice smooth. I'm making sure that it was on. Of the paper towel, I'm making it even more smooth and putting a pattern on it. And you want this let this dry for 24 hours. Before the 24 hours are up, you want to take the plastic wrap off the cup and put the cup back, put the clay back onto the cup. And that's when the outside is dry. And the next day, see, I made two. One on the left, right. That one is the one I did not use, being as smooth. And a hand paper towel is dabbing paint on it to get a pattern. And that one I put down is the one that I made as smooth as I could get it. And again, take a paper towel and dab it on it, dab all over it. And I put water in it because it then coming out. So find the lid, shake it, and dabbing it back on, then dabbing it over. And also let those two dry.